So the Lord of Gemini is Mercury. And Mercury is exalted in the fourth house. What does fourth house indicate? Family. So this person have a good supportive family. What does fourth house indicate? Mother. So this person is very connected to mother also. Fourth house indicates mental peace. So this person is generally, you will see Gemini people are tension-free people. They don't take much tension. If you go through Dipali's document, you will get all these things very handy. She have used this technique very beautifully. Right? So you take the significations of the fourth house. This person is connected to mother. This person is fortunate in terms of property. This person is fortunate in terms of vehicle. Generally gets good amounts of inheritance, right? Property comes through inheritance. So we'll get good amount of inheritance. This person will generally have a tension-free life. Even if this person is tensed, you know, these tensions are not very high, not very great. So normal tension will be there. My promotion is not happening, sir, etc. But there will be no serious problem like enemy issue, etc. These things will not be there. Getting my point? So these are a few of the things. Exalted in the fourth house, you take the significations of the fourth house and good results related to that signification happen. Now the Lagna Lord is debilitated in the 10th house. So professional life is a problem. Name, fame, and prestige in society is a problem. Now note down that name, fame, and prestige is a signification of the 10th house. Because that's why I'm mentioning it. Right? So professional life can be a problem. Name, fame, and prestige in society can be a problem. Gemini people are generally accused of something that they have never done in life. Or accused of false allegations, is what people say. False allegations are there. 10th house also indicates the, you know, what your father expects from you. So these people will not be anywhere near to the expectations of their father. Right? To achieve prominence in life will be very difficult for them. Right? To get respected from people, they have to struggle. These are the general things, right? If in the 10th house there is an exalted Venus, then these things may not be a problem because planets will change. Right now, we are not considering planets, but when planets will come, if there is an exalted Venus, then things will change. If there is an own sun Jupiter, then things will change, then things will tend to become positive. But even in that positive case, these negative traits of being born in Gemini Lagna will be there. So suppose someone is having a Jupiter in own sign in 10th house for in Gemini ascendant. So what will happen until and unless the good dasha comes? In the good dasha, the result of Jupiter in own sign in 10th house will come and the person will acquire good place in their profession. The person will be respected in the society, will have a following. That will happen when good dasha, antar dasha come, that supports Jupiter. In bad dasha, antar dashas, the problem of the professional life, the problem of getting the prestige, the problem of getting recognized will be there. Understood my point? And technically, I can tell you a few things only. I cannot tell you a whole lot of things, right? But that's why, you know, homework is essential because 10th house have many significations. So you can use all of these significations. For example, 10th house indicates sky. So Gemini person can be afraid of heights. They can have a fear from height. They can generally meet with air accidents. Right? These things can be there. Now coming to the next point. The second house lord is exalted in the 12th house. Now 12th house is all bad. How? But it is exalted, you have to tell good things only. So let me take it in a good sense. 12th house indicates expenditure. Here the planet is exalted. So this person will not spend a whole lot of money. He will think before spending. He will not be someone who spends money without thinking. This will be a person who will think before spending money. 12th house also indicates isolation. This will indicate that this is a person who doesn't like isolation. This person will not want to get alone. This person will always want to keep their family and keep their loved ones close to them. This person will always want to be in a society, be in the company of people, right? 12th house have a very peculiar trait of freedom from misery is a 12th house scenario. Freedom from misery is a 12th house scenario. So this person, Gemini person, is the one who will uplift the standards of the family. If the family is a common middle class, Gemini person have the power to take the family to higher middle class section. Getting my point? These things will be there. 12th house also indicates expenditure. And because the second lord is exalted there, this person will be an investment. He will spend money to invest it. So 12th house in a positive sense also indicates investment. Right? This person will also have very beautiful eyes because 12th house and second house both indicates eyes. So this person will have a very beautiful eye. Right? Along with this, with the second lord exalted in the 12th house, this person will generally be misunderstood. Second house indicates wise, and 12th house is the house of loss and expenditure. This person will be generally misunderstood, but will not talk bad about anyone. So generally, these people have a good amount of control in this particular matter, etc., etc. Right. Any planet in any house, Usha ji, Ketu in 10th house, you take the significations of Ketu and mix it with the 10th house. Okay. This thing done. Now going further. The second lord is debilitated in the 6th house. So diseases related to face, second house is face. Disease related to voice. Disease related to throat, three things. This person will take loans, second house, 6th house loan, second house money. So this person also takes loans, specifically personal loans this person can take, right? 6th house also indicates maternal uncle. So this person is very close to the family of maternal uncle, right? 6th house also indicates boils and pimples. So this person may have something which is like, you know, which, what to say, like, you know, if someone is having a mole right on the nose, it will be a factor which is, you know, like, like, if despite the person being very beautiful, this is a factor which makes him look a bit not that good, right? So these type of things is supposed to be there. Right? Gemini person always have this particular thing, right? Like dark circles in the eyes, no marks on the face, that kind of a particular thing, right? Second house is also Maraka along with the 7th house. So death because of disease, right? Second house indicates money, 6th house indicates servants. So a lot of money being spent on servants. Getting my point? These things are there. Understood. There are a whole lot of significations. You can add them. Okay, in the second house, there is one more way to go through it. In the second house, the 11th lord is exalted. Gemini person will always earn in life. Earnings, not two houses of money connected. This person will always earn in life. This person is supposed to get rich. Whatever are the wishes and desires of this person related to family, all of that wishes and desires will come true. If he wants a male child, he will get a male child. If he wants a female child, he will get a female child. If he wants his child to study in a foreign land, he will also study in a foreign land, etc. Right? All these things will be there. This person